72 years old, a scam artist serving a 150-year prison sentence, saying, quote, they had to know, but the attitude was sort of, if you're doing something wrong, we don't want to know, end quote.
How about that? Rick Leventhal joins us now with more from our newsroom. Rick, so what is Madoff saying about who knew what and when exactly?
Well, keep in mind, Martha, this is a convicted liar and a cheat who has virtually no credibility at this point. But it is his first interview since his arrest back in 2008. Bernie Madoff was dressed in rumpled khaki prison clothes and looked noticeably thinner, frail, and agitated, according to the reporter who interviewed him. He admits his guilt, but still defiantly pointing fingers at others, too. This is a man who stole the fortunes and ruined the lives of hundreds of investors and families, now claiming that many long-term clients made more in legitimate profits in the years before the fraud than they would have on their own. Telling the Times, quote, I would have loved for them not to lose anything, but that was a risk they were well aware of by investing in the market. In reality, they were no longer investing. Madoff is serving a 150-year sentence in North Carolina prison for giving investors interest, but spending the principal, burning through $20 billion in 16 years. Madoff is not claiming any specific banks or funds were accomplices in his Ponzi scheme or had direct knowledge of it, but he is saying they should have known and would have if they had scrutinized his actions to any degree, Martha.
Yeah, and Madoff claims to be cooperating with the efforts to recover the billions of dollars that were lost by those investors, Rick?
Cooperating in part. According to the Times, Madoff says he spent 4 days last summer meeting with attorney Irving Picard. Picard is a trustee who's trying to recover assets for the fraud victims. Madoff says he repeatedly provided useful information to Picard and his team, including the allegations that financial institutions were somehow involved. Quote, this is from Madoff. I am saying that the banks and funds were complicit in one form or another, and my information to Picard when he was here established this. But Madoff is not helping the feds working on criminal cases connected to the fraud. He's also closely monitoring news of the case, calling coverage of his son's Mark's suicide last December disgraceful. The younger Madoff hung himself in his apartment last December. And while Bernie Madoff still tries to protect those close to him, several of his staff have been indicted, and his former accountant and senior lieutenant have pleaded guilty and are cooperating with prosecutors, Martha. A lot of lawsuits still on the books.
Boy, a tragedy on so many levels. Rick Leventhal, thank you very much.
Sure.